So what exactly are parametric cells? Well, there are cells in MicroStation, just like any other cell, except they have unique properties. They allow us to place the cell and then control the variations or appearances of that cell. So one cell can actually represent multiple different features. So the file that I'm in right now is a 3D file. And to verify that, we're going to go turn on the one reference file I have attached. You can see this is a plan sheet and it's an unrotated view. I'm going to zoom back in. This is the area that we're interested in. Now I'm going to rotate my view so that you can see this is a three-dimensional view. Here's my what I call reference line. And the reference line is placed not only horizontally, but it's also placed vertically accurate. So if I snap to one end, we're going to see the elevation. It happens to be 110.1. The other end also placed at elevation. So we're going to go ahead and go back to top view. I'm going to rotate to top view. I'm going to go ahead and turn off the reference file. We're going to go to place active cell. So I'm going to go to the place cell tool. Now when I do that, what you're going to see is the active cell is a graphic cell. It's just a placeholder, but the tool that I'm in is place active cell. Now how do we get to place parametric cell? Well, if I go to my cell library, the cell library dialog displays a column called type. You can see there's graphic cell in this cell library, and there's also mostly parametric cells. Now the cell that I want to place is this one. It's a DI-G1. As I select it, you can see on the right side, there's a preview here. And that preview tells me that this is a 3D cell. You can see in the preview that this cell has four openings or four holes. We're going to see when we go to place it that we have the option of which holes we want to show. So to make this the active cell, I can either double click on it or I can right click and go to place cell. I'm going to double click. When I do that, making it the active cell, on my tool settings window, that puts me in the place cell tool. Now at the top, you're going to see where it says the active cell. Below that, you're going to see variation. When I click on this, you're going to see different options, front, left, right. These are defined when the cell is created. What these are going to determine is which opening or hole is displayed. In this case, I want to use front. Now below that, we have active angle, which is currently grayed out because I chose interactive. If I uncheck interactive, active angle becomes an option. So if you prefer to place it by active angle, you can do that. I'm going to be choosing interactive. That allows me to define the angle. Now the below that is going to be the variables. Now the variables, we can put in things like system and unit number, but also there are variables that control the appearance of the DI, like height and thickness and diameter of holes. Now, to get a better idea of what these mean, I've attached a PDF and I have it showing in view number 3. So if I turn on view number 3, you're going to see an illustration of the DI. You're going to see variables on either side and red lines pointing to what each variable controls. So this helps you to understand what the variables are defining. So I'm going to close that. I'm in view number 1, which happens to be a top view. And on view number 2, you're going to see it's a rotated view. So as I go to place this, I'll zoom in. I have it set to interactive. I'm going to do a data. And then I can interactively define the rotation. So I'm going to go ahead and rotate it this way and place it. Just like any cell, I hit reset when I'm done and the cell is placed. Now those letters will not print out. Now I can change these variables after I've placed it. So I'm going to go ahead and select the element, the parametric cell. I'm going to go to my properties dialog. On the properties dialog, you're going to see at the bottom the variables. I'm going to change my height. Right now it's currently set to 4. I'm going to change that to 6.5. And when I do this, on the right in the rotated view, you'll see the height change. The holes, what we do to hide the holes is we can set them to a diameter of 99. That means that they won't show up. I'm going to change the right diameter, which in the top view, you can see the R right now. There's no hole. I'm going to change that, and you're going to see the hole appear. I'm going to set it to 1.5. And you can see in the rotated view, the hole appears. You also see in the top view, the hole appears there. So this is a way that we can edit the variables or change the appearance of the parametric cell even after it's placed. So I'm going to go ahead and close this dialog, and I'm going to go ahead and unselect my element. I'm going to go ahead and turn on my reference file again so we can see our plan sheet. And our file has a geographic coordinate system, or GCS. And because it does, we can turn on Bing Maps. And I do this by going to my View Attributes. And on the bottom, you're going to see Background Map. Right now it's set to none. I'm going to change that to Hybrid. And when I do that, you're going to see an aerial in the background. This helps us for design validation, knowing that what is the context of our design in this area. So I'm going to go ahead and close that. I'm going to turn off the reference file. There's another file I'm going to be showing you that's going to allow us to see the finished grade in conjunction with our design. I'm going to go to File Open. It's another file that's already set up. In this file, we have a completed drainage network. You can see our DI, you can see our pipes here, and you're also seeing the finished grade. Right now, I'm currently in wireframe. To change that, I can go Shift, right-click, and on the right side, I have three shortcuts to illustration, presentation, and shaded in wireframe. I'm going to change it to illustration, and then I'm going to rotate my view, and what you can see is the finished grade. You could also see, if I rotate it like this, subsurface. So that's one way that we can, again, validate our design for elevation. So hopefully this gives you a brief introduction to parametric cells. And in this example, we were using drainage inlets. So stay tuned. There's going to be a lot more videos on how to work in 3D and how to work with parametric cells.